All right, so this is definitely one of the most popular questions I get asked. What do you do when your Dropbox is full? There's actually two approaches to this. The first is to maximize the free space that Dropbox gives you for performing certain tasks. The second is to flat out delete files that are using up too much space in your Dropbox. I'll be exploring both of these with you. There is, of course, a third option, which is to pay for Pro, Dropbox Pro. I think it costs about 10 bucks a month. All right, so the first way I'm going to show you involves going to Dropbox.com. So this is flat out Dropbox.com/home. I'm logged in. And then what you have to enter is this, get space. Don't try looking for a link. I had difficulty finding it, but if you actually type just get space here and press enter, it'll go straight to the page. Okay, so on this page, you can see a few things. Yeah, you can upgrade your account. That's gonna help, obviously, but we're gonna assume that we're not doing that right now. So I'm gonna scroll down. Refer friends to Dropbox. This is a classic. If you know friends that could benefit from Dropbox, you may recommend this to them. You can actually invite them to their email. And if they install Dropbox on a machine, then you're going to get credit for 500 megs. This is good, but personally, I don't like bothering people that much. Unless they really have a use for Dropbox, then I'm happy to recommend it to them. Because, by the way, when you recommend someone, they get 500 megs and you get 500 megs. It's kind of like not just you, they get it too. Then there's the tutorial here, get started with Dropbox. This is just a little tutorial you have to step through, a few tasks you have to do for them. You do enough of these, five steps, you get 250. It's a pretty easy way to get it. Now here's another option, following them on Twitter. Again, fairly easy. If you have a Twitter account, just do it. Or tell them why you love Dropbox. This one you can do absolutely anything. You can put a smiley face and they won't bother you. And at the end here, you can keep tabs on how much space you've earned by just clicking this link, and it's going to show you all your accomplishments on that front. Right now I've got nothing. All right, so that's the first method, really trying to maximize the space that you already do have. Now, let's say you don't want to maximize the space that you have, but you instead want to figure out what's wasting the most space, and then you want to resolve that problem. I have a tool for you. The tool is called WindYourStat. I'll be showing you how to use it. I actually did another video on it, so if you want to check it out, you can check in the description. All right, so this is WindYourStat. Instead of pointing it to a drive like I did in the previous video, I'm going to point it instead to a Dropbox. You can see that at the bottom there. Okay. So I've selected a folder and then I've selected the Dropbox, my Dropbox. All right. So once I've done that, I just have to click OK and it's going to start calculating and stuff. But I'm going to interrupt this because I have already done it in advance. All right. So the scanning is done. Now let's take a quick look. As I mentioned in the previous video, the larger the square, the bigger the file within the space that you selected. So the space I selected is my Dropbox folder. So the bigger the square, the bigger the file is taking up space in my Dropbox folder. So this is probably the easiest way to debug what's wasting the most space. If I click on this massive square over here, massive rectangle, I see that it's a video game footage from Postal 2. Okay, so it's naturally it's raw video files based on a Premiere project. Okay, makes sense. Now I know that if I delete this file, it's 127 gigs by itself. That's definitely going to make a big difference in my Dropbox folder. I can keep repeating the process by clicking these giant squares, and eventually I'll clear up enough files to reduce the space used in Dropbox. Keep in mind, you can right-click at any point and say you want to delete, send it to the recycling bin, or delete with no way to undelete. And it's also possible to simply say you want to explore there, which is one of my favorite things. You just say explore here, and it pops open a Windows Explorer window focused on that file. And that's how you can free up some space in Dropbox. I hope this helps.